Hey y'all, I'm gonna make a quick tutorial on how to animate your PowerPoints step by step so that you do not have to write so much on the board. I suggest using big bold fonts and always outlining your fonts in black so that it's easy to see from all the way in the back of the classroom. This specific font is a RY font by Rory Yakubov. I teach algebra and I'll link it below. So here's the secret. The secret is making everything that you talk about a separate text box. That's really all that it is. And once everything is a separate text box, then you animate everything individually in the order that you want to talk about the things the way that they come up on the slide. Just as a side note, when I'm making an unconventional shape like a radical, I always use the freehand shape tool. It's very helpful. You can press shape and it'll be in the top right hand corner if you're using Keynote. Once you have all your text boxes on the screen, what you're going to go ahead and do is you're going to click on each text box individually and animate them separately in the order that you want them to come up on the screen while you're giving your lecture. For each of my letters, I'm using the drop animation, and then for the lines, I'm using the line draw animation. Once I'm done, this is what it would look like while I was presenting, and notice that the lines come on the screen just like I was drawing them on the board. That's the whole process in a nutshell. Make separate text boxes for everything you want to come up on the screen. Animate them in the order that you want them to come up on the screen. What I'm about to show you now is just extra if you just want to keep following along for whatever reason. So I'm just making my first example of the problem. So I'm putting everything on the screen like I normally would. And then I am going to animate each and every one of them separately the way that I would do the problem up on the board if I was writing on the board. Once I do that, then I'm going to check to see how it looks and if it's coming up the way that I expect it to. And then when I'm done with that, I am going to duplicate the slide and change the numbers for the next couple of examples, because once the slide is animated, all I have to do is duplicate the slide and the animations will still stay in the same order. That is the time hack here. And then that's it in a nutshell. I hope that is helpful. Let me know if you want anything else explained to you guys. Bye. Pretty sure I made a mistake in some of those slides. Please don't judge me. I caught them later. Bye.